Happy holidays, everyone, and welcome to the final PNN Friday show of 2020. I'm Shad Claus, and I don't know about you guys, but I'm so glad this year is finally coming to a close. While normal life as we knew it took a sudden twist back in March, we have done our best to maintain our holiday spirit during what's been a crazy year. Speaking of crazy, we kick off our show this week with a crazy holiday-themed game show. While the pandemic has made it difficult to produce our regular PNN segments, JVR went in the box, so to speak, as her little brothers try to figure out what's in her new holiday challenge.
What's up, you guys? It's your girl, JVR, and today I'm here to bring you the What's in the Box Challenge Christmas edition.
Now, you guys are probably wondering, what is the What's in the Box Challenge? It's a game where you stick an object in a box and the person has to feel around, then decide what the item is. Here are the rules. You must keep your eyes closed at all times. You can only touch the item for 3 seconds, and do not say the answer until the time is called. Other than that, enjoy the game. The first two items are sugar and marshmallows.
3, 2, 1, eyes closed. Okay. 1, 2, 3, take them out. Say the answer. Marshmallows!
The second two items is one, an O for the stocking, and a reindeer.
5, go. 1, 2, 3, take your hands out. Okay, what y'all think it is?
Reindeer!
Oh.
Okay, y'all both got that right.
The third items is an elf and a house.
3, 2, 1. 1, 2, 3. What's the answers?
Elf.
It's the house.
Now here is the scoreboard. My brother Aiden is in first place with a score of 3 out of 3, and my other brother is in second place with a score of 2 out of 3. Do you think he will catch up? The fourth item, they both get the same thing. It is snowflakes.
Okay, put your hand back in the box. 1, 2, 3. Pull out. What do you guys think it is?
Snowflakes.
Huh?
Snowflakes.
Oh.
The fifth item is a Christmas tree.
Close your eyes. Stick your hands in. 1, 2, 3. Take them out. What do you think it is?
Mountain.
Mountain.
The 6 items are the letters J and M.
Okay, stick your hand in.
Where's the hand thing?
1, 2, 3. Put it down. What do you guys think it is?
A letter A. A letter A.
Who do you think it is, Aiden?
A letter A.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, you got it wrong.
It's J. A! Since they are both tied with a score of 4 out of 6, I decided to change it up a bit. They both have to touch the item, then finally guess that color.
3, 2, 1.
Hey!
EJ, can you grab yours?
Where is it?
Go, no, put your hand back in it. You gotta feel it. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Okay, what is it?
It's a...
You guys can open, wait, don't open your eyes. Okay, you can open your eyes.
It's a...
Gray ornament.
Ornament?
It's a gray ornament.
It's a gray. It's
what color do you think yours was, Aiden?
Silver.
Congratulations, Aiden, for winning the What's in the Box challenge. Aiden stole the win when he scored a 5 out of 7. And for my other little brother, he came in with a score of 4 out of 7. Better luck next time. I hope you guys enjoy my mini challenge and maybe we'll try it out on your own at home. Signing out for PNN, I'm Javiera Gamble. Have a nice break, MHS.
The wrestling season is underway, and Coach Maldonado has been trying to keep the team in check, battling through a pandemic, and hoping to add more state qualifiers to the MHS Wall of Fame.
The 2020 wrestling season has begun, and despite the trying times with COVID, the boys are taking the proper cautions and staying healthy to make sure that their season is successful. Coach Maldonado has been doing his best to coach the boys to the best of their ability and keep them safe while training for their meets.
We're doing a lot more. We're doing a pretty good job as far as, separating guys in the locker room. Our wrestling room, luckily, we have the biggest wrestling room in the state, so we're able to separate guys. We're keeping guys in pods and separating guys. We actually also bought a fogger that disinfects the whole wrestling room. Also, we disinfect the locker room, our bleacher area. So we're trying to take all the precautions we can to make sure that everybody's safe.
It's been kind of challenging. But we've been working through it, and we've been working hard at getting to practice every day and just trying to keep us going and not get shut down. Because as you know, middle school season got shut down, and so that was kind of like a big wake-up call for us to just do the right thing and keep our masks and social distance and everything like that. But yeah, it's basically it. You know, Maldi, you're going to keep us together and keep us right. So.
Despite the always looming possibility of COVID, the wrestlers are still training hard and have high expectations for the season.
My goal for this season is trying to make it as far as possible. Last year I was just a regional alternate on my first year of varsity. I want to try to make it to, I want to end on a podium on this year, on state.
My goals and expectations for this season is to, as a team, make it far, like all do good, and as an individual, I hope to make it to state and place.
With the boys ready for action, Coach Maldonado hopes that the team can maintain the same success despite the current climate.
At this point, we're just happy to just being able to compete right now. We're just going to work every day, and we're going to work hard every day. We're going to try to improve on a daily basis. We are definitely a better team than we were in our first dual meet, which was a week ago. So all we can do and all we can ask the guys to do is to show up every day, protect themselves outside of the wrestling room by social distancing, wearing our masks, stay away from large gatherings, but that's pretty much all we can do. Just remind the kids that every day is kind of a blessing, and we just show up every day and we'll see what happens.
With many DAC meets and tournaments on the horizon, we hope that the boys not only stay safe and healthy, but they also perform to the best of their ability throughout the season. Signing off from PNN, I'm Janaya Tuggle.
Speaking of the pandemic, both boys and girls basketball have concluded their temporary shutdowns after COVID plagued both of their teams. However, both are now back in action and look to make an impact on the court.
Both boys and girls basketball seasons have started to begin our winter sports here at MHS. But due to COVID-19, both teams have been quarantined for the next few weeks. The girls started off the season strongly, winning 4 straight games. And the boys started off the season with a close loss to a very good Fort Wayne Snyder team. Here's how both coaches plan to keep their teams physically and mentally sharp and ready to face off against the next opponent following the quarantine.
Number one priority all season has been the health and safety of our guys, so we've been being very cautious, making sure we wear a mask in practice. When you do take your mask down, being 6 feet apart. And then when you go home, making sure we're washing our hands and things like that. So far, so good. We have been quarantined, and that's been difficult because number one, you're missing practice time. But we've just been keeping the guys encouraged, making sure they do some at-home workouts. And when we come back, we would appreciate being on the court a lot more.
So we have all the basketball girls on Google Classroom. So we've been posting workouts, both cardio, trying to stay in shape. That's our biggest key and our biggest asset to our team is when we're in shape, we just wear teams down. So we're trying to keep our cardio up. We're also posting ball handling workouts, which is difficult if they don't have space to do at home, but we're just trying the best that we can. We are also watching a lot of film, trying to learn from our mistakes in the past, and just trying to stay sharp until we can get back on the court.
Going into the season, we had very high expectations. We returned all five of our starters. Of course, one going to prep school. And we want to just say we're wishing Keon the best of luck and success. We still have four of our five starters coming back, Dylan Cody, Juwan Bandy, Dorian Harris, and AJ Dixon. And we got a host of other varsity and JV guys ready to step up and make a huge impact this year.
Well, we were very excited for the season. We are senior heavy, and a lot of these girls have been playing varsity basketball since they were freshmen. We always tell them good things happen when you play hard. So our goal is just to keep getting better each and every game, each and every day, and just try to stay healthy and see if we can get through the year.
Make sure you come out and support the Pirates, girls and boys, as they come out of the quarantine looking to play a promising season. Signing off for PNN, I'm Shad Ulrich.
As we know, 2020 has been a crazy year, especially for celebrities. Iman is here to recap all the recent celebrity babies and the social media followings they've obtained.
Since the original quarantine in the spring of 2020, there have been a lot of pandemic pregnancies. More specifically, in the last 3 weeks, a lot of our social media stars and celebrities that we look up today have had some quarantine babies. First on the list, we have Kentrell Deshaun Gordon. More likely known as NBA Youngboy. NBA Youngboy is an American artist widely known for rapping. His hit singles are Make No Sense, Lonely Child, Valuable Pain, and many more. NBA Youngboy welcomed a daughter on November 26th, Thanksgiving Day, as his sixth child by the name of Cody Capri. She was 7.5 pounds when she arrived, and her mother, Drea Simone, could not be more thankful for her. After all, she was born on Thanksgiving Day. Next on the list, we have Ayla Faith Prince, the daughter of Damon and Bianca. Damon and Bianca are widely known YouTubers with multiple YouTube channels who have accumulated at least 3 million subscribers on all their platforms, if not more. On November 30th, Damon and Bianca posted these photos of baby Ayla, as well as a vlog of Bianca in labor and giving birth.
I didn't poop.
I swear to God, you pooped on yourself.
But they didn't tell me that.
She cleaned it up.
This girl Bianca pooped on herself. I'm the roaster, y'all. Listen.
This is their fourth child, and they have many more on the way. And last but not least on the list is baby True. True Destiny, to be exact. True Destiny was born on December 8th to parents Trey Traylor and Cindy Marie. Trey Traylor and Cindy Marie have their own YouTube channels, in which they have millions of subscribers. Trey Traylor is a known artist, especially in the YouTube realm, which is in a duo group with his brother, Armand. They have hit singles like Right Back and many more. Trey Traylor shared this photo of baby True. Welcome her into the real world. Guess we can all say that there are many additions to our world with these pandemic pregnancies and quarantine births. Many of our influencers that we know today have newly become mothers and fathers or just added an addition to their family. Hey, do you know anyone who had a pandemic pregnancy? Signing off from PNN, I'm Iman.
Game shows are always fun, but when two friends get together to try and figure out words, anything can happen.
Welcome to Heads Up Holiday Edition. In this corner, we have Asia. In this corner, we have Desiree. They each have 15 seconds to guess as many holiday-themed words as they can. Here's how it works. One is guessing the word while the other is describing the word. If they get the word correct, they tilt the phone down and earn a point. Get it wrong, they have to tilt the phone up, resulting in no points at all. Let's see who wins. First up, Asia. She has 15 seconds to guess as many holiday theme words as she can.
Oh, it's a song. Oh,
Christmas tree.
Yeah.
Okay, you put it on the Christmas tree.
Ornament.
Okay, old people use it to walk.
Cane.
Yeah, but
candy cane. Yeah.
Hold on.
Christmas. I mean, Santa.
Yeah. Blank on the shelf.
Elf. Mm-hmm.
Next up, Desiree. She also has 15 seconds to guess as many words as she can. Can she beat Asia, who scored 5?
Frosty.
Snowman.
You put this on the tree and it shines.
White?
Mm-hmm.
You open it.
Present.
Mm-hmm. You put it on the fireplace and...
Stockings.
Uh-huh. Rudolph.
Reindeer.
Comet. Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess we have to call it a tie. They each got 5 words in 15 seconds. Maybe next time there could be a tiebreaker. Signing off from PNN, I'm Dorian Cunningham.
While we finally leave 2020 behind, who knows what could be in store for us in 2021? Luckily, these MHS prognosticators have some ideas.
With 2020 hitting us with a load of surprises, I believe a majority of people are delighted that this year is finally coming to an end. With 2021 just around the corner, some people have a variety of predictions for how next year will turn out in the categories of sports, music, fashion, and TV and film.
I think the Cleveland Browns, I think they'll win next season because they're pretty good right now. And you still have the draft that's coming up. That's going to be probably next season. So that speaking on who they draft, I think the Cleveland Browns, they'll be pretty decent on coming on next season.
In 2021, I feel like fashion will be like more, well, right now it's already more like vintage like, and people are bringing back like the old school styles and stuff like that, so I feel like they're gonna bring it back even more, but they're gonna like change the whole game of it. And I also feel like fashion, it won't be so expensive as it was in 2020. Like, everybody wanted to buy like a lot of expensive stuff, but I feel like 2021, fashion-wise, people will learn to look good and not so expensive things, because you don't need expensive things to look good.
I think it's going to be more rappers, like more rappers coming out and like getting more attention. They're going to be able to do like more shows and stuff once all this COVID and stuff in. And
I actually think that it's not going to get better, and I have an interesting reason why I think that is. With television and film production being slowed down a lot, obviously theaters have closed down across the country. There are a lot of out-of-work creators that are out there, but I think because of the nature of film and television, the money that's involved in those ventures, and the desire for a lot of people to have some sort of entertainment while they're at home, I think the market is actually going to get flooded with a lot of people creating a lot of things that aren't necessarily very good. So there will be some very good film and television that's made, but as a whole, I think the overall quality of film and television is actually going to decrease.
While there is really no telling of what's in store for 2021, but hopefully good things are to come. Signing off from PNN, I'm Roderick Washington.
As 2020 comes to an end, many people are looking forward to starting fresh in the new year. While 2020 was disappointing in many aspects, including the pandemic shutting down most of the country, 2021 could lead to a vaccine and return to normal. Many students at Maribel have resolutions and goals leading into 2021.
My New Year resolutions are to be in my bag, get all the toxic people out of my life, and to better myself, because no one is perfect.
My first New Year's resolution is to save my money. I spend entirely too much money on foolishness things, and I just need to save more. My second New Year's resolution is to cook at least one new thing every week, you know, so I can learn how to cook more. And my third resolution is to work on time management. I am horrible about getting things done on time and spreading out my time.
While many students have resolutions for 2021, most of us are really glad to see this past dreadful year come to an end.
I'm glad that 2020 is over, because a lot of bad things have happened this year. Kobe died, that started all of it, and I'm just ready for it to be over to unlock new blessings in 2021.
I'm glad 2020 is coming to an end, because it's been a tragic year between the pandemic and losing our senior year. And I'm also just sick of wearing masks. So hopefully in 2021, we have new beginnings.
As 2020 finally comes to a close, we hope everyone achieves their goal or sticks to their resolution. For me, I just hope that the class of 2021 can celebrate with a true graduation ceremony and go out in style. Signing off from PNN, I'm Dorian Cunningham.
Finally, we go into the PNN vault to spread a little bit of cheer with this classic throwback holiday music video that is now timeless. Enjoy this look back at the magic of the holiday season.
How about a song to get you into the holiday spirit?
Sunset, I sweep the snow from my doorstep. I just can't help but stop and grin. It's like I'm 10 years old again. And everywhere I go, I can feel it. Some say it moves like a spirit. It falls on us once a year, like it came on a midnight clear. The soul of this season is a gift. When love came down to let's live, let's open up and let our hearts embrace this moment for Christmas. Before the sunrise, I sneak downstairs to sparkling eyes, and oh, what joy it brings to me. The family around our Christmas tree, and I thank the Lord for his favor as we sing the songs of the Savior. Our Savior. The soul of this season is a gift. When love came down to let us live, let's open up and let our hearts embrace this moment.
Thanks for joining us for our December show. We hope everyone has a safe and amazing holiday season. We'll see everyone back in 2021, and hopefully we can look forward to a great year. Signing off from PNN, I'm Shad Claus. Have a great holiday, MHS.